Well, hello there. It is the day after Christmas, and just thought I'd do a little update for the vlog here, even though I didn't have any work to show. I'm up at the property right now because we had a little bit of a white Christmas. Actually, my first time having one. Yeah, a little bit of snow on the ground from the night before, and then it was pretty much freezing temperatures all the day of Christmas, so thought I'd see what it looked like up here on the property, if there was any snow and how much was left. You can see we do have a little bit here going down the side of the road. A little bit of snow that's been shielded from the sun has remained, and I saw it that way pretty much all the way up the road here on the way to the property. Let's see what we got going on up here so far. Not much of anything. But, we'll see what happens when we get up here into the shaded spots. Anything back here? A little bit of snow left in those cracks right there. Down here that was shaded. You can see some more snow down there in the shaded area on the road. I was going to try to take my alternate path down there to the rock area, but I don't know, these leaves are kind of wet. Don't know if I feel like walking through that, so I might just have to take the long way around. Or will I? Whoa! Well, I slipped a little bit. Not too bad. I managed to stop myself from falling. Glad I was recording when that happened. Look at this. I got a little bit of snow here. Not too bad. And here's the old rock. I need to find something to clear out these holes a bit better. I actually went ahead and purchased that Dexpan stuff. And it's actually supposed to be getting delivered today, so between tomorrow and the next couple of days, I think we'll have suitable weather. I'm gonna bring it out here and see if I can do something with this rock. Well, let's go take a look at the old dig spot. Oh God, yeah, that's a bit slippery. Don't want to slip here. Oh God, yes, it's rather cakey over here. I thought the leaves might help kind of, I don't know, do something with that, but don't think that's the case. Don't want to slip in this area. Oh, we got some ice and stuff. I don't know if I want to walk down there. My shoes are already kind of goopy, but I'll see if I can show you from here. And all that oddly shaped ice. In terms of the, you know, news on the property or anything, you know, I've had to take several days here of not really doing anything. I tried calling the soil test guys, the guy, you know, who I said I was gonna see if he would match the other dude's price. He couldn't do it. I tried to call the other guy to schedule it, and no answer. Maybe he took Christmas week off or something. So I kind of just been sitting here twiddling my thumbs, not really having anything to do regarding the property, at least. But I don't know, I'm trying to figure out what I want to do, if that's even like a sane thing to say with, you know, having no budget and the issues with buying another property and all that kind of stuff. You know, I mean, there's obviously the option continue with this, just spend what money we have and try to make full steps. Find another piece of property in a more tiny house friendly area. That's a consideration. Or just stop everything and just sit back and try to save more money and figure it out at a later time. You know, like I said before, we have considered other places, other options, and we've kept our eyes open for opportunities to open up in other places, and have, to some extent, kind of thought about ultimately wanting to go to those places and just kind of starting out here for a while. And I guess the question now is, do we still do that, even though our plans here were, you know, kind of disrupted? Or try to, you know, take that big leap and start somewhere else where we were kind of interested in ending up anyway? That's just something I've kind of been giving more thought this week, since I couldn't do anything else, is trying to, you know, since you put the work, you put the drive down for a minute, you kind of just say, well, there's nothing else I can do. It kind of gives you a moment to just sit and think and kind of gauge your feelings about things. It's hard to be like, yeah, well, maybe I'll just do this or maybe I'll do that, because we don't just have the money to just do whatever. But we do kind of have the freedom, if that's the right word, to take chances on things. So I guess that's kind of the consideration. What is the best way to invest in something? And I don't know, I guess that's kind of my thought process right now, trying to figure out what to do in that regard. And obviously what is financially, physically possible. Obviously the issue with just packing it in on this project and trying to move somewhere else is like what we've already done here. It's kind of weird to leave it unfinished. I would definitely try to clean it up the best I can. And, you know, like I said, I want to try to conquer that rock at least, or at least try that stuff out. So we'll see what that project resolution is. Well, I decided to just call it early. Not much to do up there. I like getting out of the house and kind of taking in the sun and whatnot, but I don't know. Just figured I'd call it for the day. If I hold the camera right here, oh, right there. Right there. When I talk, it makes the noise. What's happening? Is that good? Talking? Right there? Whew. Okay, it's not making the noise when I hold it right here. I don't know why it makes that noise, but it's obnoxious. Well, we're back here for day two of the, fourth attempt at the rock. And here's the stuff that I bought. It's I think I called it Dex Max yesterday, I don't remember, but it's Dexpan. And so supposedly all we gotta do is mix it with water and put it in our holes. I don't know if the holes are big enough. I don't know if they're too deep or not deep enough. We're pretty much in the temperature range for this stuff today. There's three different kinds of it, and I got the one for the lowest temperature since we're in winter. I don't think we have the ideal circumstances or tools at our disposal, but I don't know. I'll fill up these holes with something and see if it works. Well, I cleaned the holes out the best I could using a plastic knife here that I kind of whittled down with the rock to fit into these holes. And so we got to use a 1.5-inch drill bit, which I don't believe mine was. I don't remember the size, but I'm pretty sure it's a good bit less than an inch. Combine almost 1/2 gallon of water with the 11-pound bag of this mix, but I don't know if I'll be needing that much, so I gotta figure out what I'm gonna do about that. And then you wanna pour it into the holes within 15 minutes. 10 to 15 minutes of mixing it. So, I don't have a drill it recommends using to stir it up. I'll probably be using a stick. $40 down the drain. So there's what's inside. It's a bag of the mix. And this is what I'm gonna use to try and mix up what I expect to use, and then kind of hold it as a spout to be able to pour it into the holes. So hopefully that will work. Got some gloves, got my safety glasses on. If I can put this somewhere where it'll stay because nothing's flat around here. And I got my neck gaiter thing. Did I put that on right? No. There. To try and help prevent excess inhalation of material. I have no idea how much that is. Maybe a pound? Or two? Three? No idea what I'm doing. It's bubbling. That's a bit scary. It says something about blowouts on the warning there. Decided to just use this plastic knife to stir this, and I'm kind of regretting that. Well, the camera cut off on me. Hopefully I can finish this vlog out, but as you can see, it's seeping down there. And this is what we ended up with. I tried to pour it, you know, intentionally and whatnot, but it's just, I don't know. We didn't have the right tools to work with, so it is what it is. At this point, I'm so unsure about this, I don't expect it to work. I did kind of miss that hole right there, but my intention wasn't to fill all of them up, because they say, you know, how much distance you need between each one. I think I have these way closer than they need to be. But yeah, it kind of just went everywhere. So it was like after that point, it was just whatever. So I guess now we wait to see how this does not work. Well, as you can see, it's pretty boggy up there. So I brought some stuff back to the Jeep, and I'm just gonna get some tools here and do some cleanup while I'm, you know, just waiting out the rest of the day and to see if there's any noticeable impact from that Dexpan. It's supposed to take about 24 hours to work, I think, but it said I think you might notice some effects within a couple of hours or something, so I don't know. I'll just kill some time up here, do a little bit of raking and trimming and keep an eye on it. Well, I went ahead and raked up this area that I was complaining about yesterday. Made a bit clearer path. There was a rock down there that seemed kind of loose, more looser than I remembered, so I moved it down into the big hole. But yeah, now we got nice little clear trail again. Well, I think this is where we're gonna leave it today. It's only been about an hour since I put it in, and of course there's no visible sign of any effect. So I don't know if that means anything. Maybe it just means it hasn't been long enough. I mean, it is supposed to take about 24 hours, so I don't think 1 hour is gonna be too promising, but we'll see. This is the leftover that we had. It's a drying out. There's a lot less water at the top than there was when I first put it there. I'm just gonna leave it because I don't have anywhere to put it. And maybe that'll kind of, if this doesn't really prove to do anything, maybe that'll kind of give me an idea of what the mixture itself is doing or something. Well, that was interesting. I was getting ready to leave, and I'm down here on the road, and I was walking up over here because there was a rock right there that I moved, and it rolled down and came all the way down here. Thankfully, it just landed like right on the edge of the road. No one was around, so that was good. But when I was coming up, there was like a poof of smoke and a little pop up there. Was that another one? Did I just capture it? So it is doing something. Something is smoking up there. I wonder if it's the jug. I hope there's not a bad chemical reaction happening. I better go check on that, I think. Yeah, it looks like the smoky bit is coming from the jug. I think it's calming down now. Kind of concerned, like, should it Should I go check it? Is it safe? I don't want it popping in my face. Try to take some kind of safety precaution here. Let's go check it out. Oh yeah, it dried out and expanded. Look at that. That's cool. So was the poppage all from that, or did some of it come from this thing? Well, I'm glad I came back to check that rock. I wouldn't have caught that, I don't think, if I hadn't done that. I guess I'll wait a little bit longer just to make sure things are okay. I don't want to leave it if it's, you know, potentially gonna have any issues. So what I decided to do was move this down here into the dig area so that if it's generating any heat, I think it's okay. You know, I picked it up and moved it around, but it does have some kind of slightly like heated up melted plastic look to it, and I don't know if it's done, so I don't necessarily want to put it in the vehicle with me. So I figured maybe right there is a better place to keep it in case it's generating any heat, so it's just surrounded by dirt.
Well, we're back at the property. Whoa,
heading on up.
Time to go check on the rock.
I am so confident that it worked that I am bringing no tools with me. Making our way down. Get ready for the big unveiling. Heading up to the rock. And it doesn't look any different really than yesterday. One of the questions I had was whether or not the water in the mix might drain out too soon, just like the water that I put in here before, so maybe it didn't stay hydrated long enough. Yeah. No result. I'm beginning to think this rock is a metaphor for this whole endeavor. It's kind of interesting, like this stuff here is kind of like dry and solid. This, I don't know, it's still got like a moist kind of nature to it, and to my understanding that's not how it's supposed to be, unless of course, you know, this may have been kind of powderized and then dew from the overnight may have made it that way. But if you remember the other thing yesterday, what you call it, the jug, it was very powdery looking, so this may have become powder and then like rehydrated overnight from, you know, morning dew from the cold temperature. Unless that's an indication that something went wrong with the mixture. I don't know if it would be saturated like this or not, but you can see like this, it's solid, it didn't turn into powder or anything, and what we have here on the ground hardened, but it's soft from the moisture, I guess. So maybe that's what it is. It did dry out and kind of do its thing. It just didn't stay dry. It kind of sucks to spend $40 on something that's not looking like it's gonna work. Again, you know, it could be due to me not having the mixture right, or maybe the hole's not being big enough. You know, we weren't dealing with ideal circumstances according to the directions. But I don't know, it may not be that big of a deal if we continue either this project or anything around here. I'm sure there'll be more rocks to try it out on. but yeah, it's kind of an expensive, you know, loss money just throw away. Should have just bought the sledgehammer and more chisels and tried to split it manually, I guess. But that's, I guess that's the conclusion for now for the Dexpan endeavor. Taking another L on this project. I don't know. Am I getting too, like, pessimistic now? More than I already was? Anyway. I don't know. See what's next up. What's on the horizon. At least we got a pretty view today. Clouds kind of give it a bit of atmosphere. It is a bit chilly, though. I guess we can kind of test our moisture theory on the tub here. That's very powdery still. I mean, if it was just overnight moisture, you would think that this would be just as saturated, no? So I don't know, maybe it's just the mixture in the rock didn't work out. I am befuddled.